Mr. McMurray. Mr. McMurray, could you come here, please? Mr. William tells me, Mr. McMurray, that you've been awfully troublesome about your admission shower. Is this true? Please understand. I know that you're trying to orientate yourself with everyone on the ward, but all in due time. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Mr. Brandon, but everyone here must follow the rules. Now, shall we get back to Friday's meeting? Closing on Friday, we were discussing Mr. Harding's problem concerning his wife. Mr. Harding stated that his wife was extremely well endowed in the bosom area, and this made him uncomfortable because she got stares in the street. Now, Mr. Harding, you know that's not her fault. Stop! Don't you dare, Mr. McMurphy. Get back in that dorm and put on your greens. Once you finish showing off your manly physique and your gaudy underpants, you need to return to your room and get dressed. Oh, Mr. McMurphy, I wasn't suggesting more shock. I was suggesting an operation. Oh, it's very simple, really. Only minor, nothing invasive. We've had quite a success rate on aggressive patients. First horse, Cheswick, and now Volume Vivid. I hope you're finally satisfied. Playing with human lives is into some sort of god. I hope you're satisfied, McMurphy.